The proposal by a section of NRM cadres calling themselves Transformer Cadres Association Uganda to have the country's president elected by parliament has continued to ignite debate for electoral reforms in the country. The Forum for Democratic Change has come out to castigate the proposal, saying it's aimed at shielding President Yoweri Museveni from tough political competitions.
As the party, we are concerned because we are aware in this country such amendments are started by people who don't think that hold power. That is how the removal of term limits started, when people started putting on dry banana weaves and we thought they were jokers.
Addressing the weekly press conference at their party headquarters in Najjanankumbi, Kampala, the FDC Deputy Secretary General revealed that the party prefers the proportional representation system, where a number of members of parliament held by a political party in parliament is determined by the percentage of the number of popular votes received. In this electoral system, FDC wants Ugandans to remain with the right to vote for the president directly, but also vote for political parties in parliamentary elections.
To have an amendment, to have what we would call proportional representation, whereby the votes casted on the president, even if one has lost, do not go for nothing. That the percentage of the votes that you have at the presidential level are used to determine the number of MPs you have. So that we may not even need to go and directly vote the MPs, but you vote the president who moves around the country to even campaign for his party.
FDC has condemned unbearable charges which schools are levying, struggling parents as schools reopen following a prolonged closure. The Blue Party has called on school managers to wear a human face.
We want to thank them for having started schools. But I must assure you, but some of the requirements that some of the schools are asking are abnormal. Many of you went to school. If you look at the list of requirements, where on earth did we ever pay loans for the school?
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.